Global ManyCam Strategies 2018 here in Berlin. I'm here with Richard Schouten from Cytec Services. Thanks for being here with us and for taking the time for this interview.
I was director of maintenance and turnarounds. And today I'm the business unit director for innovation at the Chemelot site. And we have two parts. One is the chemical campus, where we develop new types of products. And we have the industrial park, which is about asset management, and I'm responsible for the industrial park.
What do you currently consider the main challenges in manufacturing and production in the chemical industry?
The big challenges is the energy transition we are going to, and CO2 reduction. These are the main two challenges for the whole chemical industry.
You're one of our business partners here at the conference. Please tell us more about your services that Cytec is offering to the attendees here.
Basically, we start with digitization. And we can offer predictive analytics for equipment, for processes, so the processes in the plant, but also predict energy consumption and then try to reduce the energy. And around it, we have a whole team of engineers, technicians, management to actually implement those projects, which you then have to do to optimize your plant.
We've seen some mega mergers in the past years, and how it affected the organizations that were involved. In a market where growth is connected to M&A almost every time, what is your advice for merging plants, technology, and humans?
I think there are more specialized producers going to emerge. So you get more from a bio-based or from a recycle chemistry. And this is a whole different type of chemistry which is going to happen in the future. So you get divestments, you get specialist operators. And I believe, well, that's good for us, right, to have a good asset management team on board, which can help you. And let the chemical plants focus on producing chemicals, and let the asset managers or the digitization companies focus on their core business, and try to set up an ecosystem rather than have these huge companies like BASF or Shell or whatever. They will still exist in the future, but I believe there's a broad spectrum of specialized chemicals for the future that will bring new companies.
An hour ago, you've had a presentation in which you talked about digitization from an organizational point of view.
Yep.
You said it's not about technology, it's about people. So could you briefly summarize or explain your perspective on that again?
So the technology is the easy part. As other presentations or presenters said, you have Google, you have Microsoft, you have AspenTech, you have a lot of companies who focus on the technical part, and as long as you invest in it, you can do nearly everything today. But how to get your people on board and make sure that the expertise and the knowledge of your own people are being brought into the system? Because the technical system without the expertise is still nothing. And this is hard. We're doing it for 5 years and it's really hard.
And what do you think are the main issues for companies when implementing a digital strategy?
Like I said, getting the people on board.
So that's it.
So that's really it. Make sure that they are connected, that they feel they add value, that they feel that also in the future they are still valuable for the company. And we want to go to the autonomous plant. And the autonomous plant reduces the headcount of a chemical plant. That's for certain. So still you need to have those experience and this knowledge of those people. You have to bring it into your future outlook where you have less people to operate your plants.
What will chemical manufacturing look like in 10 years?
From our point of view, we believe that the basic operations, so if you look at the chemical plants, you have a certain product. And as long as it is within bandwidth, this operation is done by the system. Doesn't matter what kind of system. And it also takes decisions. So if the market is changing, the system can make its decision to either reduce capacity or run for a period of time and then stop the plant because it's economically viable, let's say. So I think the systems can make these decisions. But still you have anomalies. Everything which goes outside the normal bandwidth, you still need highly experienced and trained people to solve these issues. And I think that will be the difficult part and the challenge for us all.
What made you come to this conference? Why are you here and what are your expectations?
We come here every year, so we have always people here. And this year it was about digitization, Industry 4.0. And I wanted to contribute with what we have done the last 6 years and to let people know that it's technology is one. And I hear on a lot of conferences people talk about technology. But like I said, it's about the people. And this is what I wanted to share. That's what I did.
And I hope you're going to have some good networking, good discussions with your industry colleagues and Hope you enjoy the rest of the conference.
I think
Thank you very much.
Thank you.